Today's vlog is about trees which are suitable for bees. Albert Einstein once said, when bees would be extinct, humans would extinct within 2 to 4 years. So to avoid that, we're going to show you some trees that produce a lot of flowers and also, of course, nectar and pollen. So let's go into the nursery and see some trees that are suitable for bees and bumblebees. Gleditia trachycanthus sunburst. Well, what's the difference with a normal Gleditia trachycanthus? That's different things. This one has no thorns. When the leaves sprout out, they're very yellow and they stay almost the whole summer through yellow. Of course, it turns a bit more green during the summer. But then if the new shoots appear, they will be very yellow as well. And also in the autumn, it turns again deep, rich yellow as well. Then it has more horizontal branching and it has a very curved crown. It grows in all different directions. It's never straight. And also the trunk is much more grooved of that of a normal Gleditia trachycanthus. Also, it hardly has any fruits hanging in it. You can do lots of things with it. You can make a small avenue with it, but also as a solitary in a park, it's also extremely nice. It doesn't grow as fast as a normal Gleditia trachycanthus would do. It gets about 10 meters high when it's mature. Very diverse, nice tree, Gleditia trachycanthus sunburst. This is Syringa yosicae, and normally you would think of a Syringa as a multi-stemmed shrub, but this one can also quite well be grown into a small single-stemmed tree. It doesn't grow too fast and it gets about 4 to 5 meters in height when it's mature. The flowers appear in May and you can see them flowering now. They actually smell delicious as well, and they attract a lot of bumblebees, butterflies and normal bees too. So you can also plant it in a private garden, in a small park, but also on a rooftop garden, for example. So you can use it in a lot of different ways. It's also extreme winter hardy, this one. Very nice small tree, Syringa yosicae. This is Sorbus vulgari Emil, quite new cultivar in Sorbus. It doesn't get too big, about 8 to 10 meters in height when it's mature. These are multi-stemmed, but they're also used a lot as a single-stemmed tree. You can see them blooming right now. It's mid-May at the moment, and they attract a lot of bees and bumblebees, so it's a very good bee-friendly tree. They have a white side underneath the leaves, so when the leaves, when the flowers are gone later on in summer, when the wind plays through the leaves, it's always a bit gray looking as well. So that's quite attractive, and the leaves turn red orange in the autumn, and then those flowers will have turned into small red fruits that hang in the trees, and birds can feed on them later on. So it's a quite versatile tree through all seasons. Sorbus vulgari Emil. The bees are very happy with flowers in the trees, and I'm very happy when you put your thumb up. This is Crataegus media pole scarlet, or red thorn in English. It was discovered in the UK in about 1860 by a sir called Sir Paul. It's called red thorn in English. It's a tree that grows quite slowly, doesn't get too big, maybe 6 to 8 meters. Now the crown is still quite narrow, but it will get more round when it gets more mature. It's a tree that doesn't like when it's totally dry, but it can withstand paved surfaces. You can use it in a smaller garden because it doesn't get too big, so it's a very attractive tree when it's flowering. Crataegus media pole scarlet. This is Aeschylus mutabilis induta. A very nice tree that stays quite small. It gets up 3 to 5 meters depending on the grafting height. Usually it's grafted onto a single stem, like at 150 or at 2 meters high. But these have been grafted on a small foot, so to speak. So this is the understem, and this is the place where it was grafted. And here is the graft itself that has grown into an Aeschylus mutabilis induta. It grows quite slowly, so it's very suitable to be in a smaller garden or in a patio garden or in the front yard as a solitary. And the flowers are appearing in May, June, and they're a bit psalm pink and a bit yellow as well. It is not vulnerable for the leaf miner, so it's a nice healthy tree that can also stand in full pavement. So, nice tree, Aeschylus mutabilis induta. Well, I hope you enjoyed our video about trees which are suitable for bees and that you learned something as well. If you have any questions, please take a look at our website or contact our sales staff. See you next time.